In this video, I will be reviewing the Sakumaru from Fine King. Hello guys, I'm Chef Panko and I used to work in a Japanese restaurant. Make sure to subscribe to know more about cooking and knives. Before we start with the review, I want to go over some disclosures. I bought this knife with my own money. No one sends them to me or paid me to use this knife or to make this video. If you like this video, please give this video a thumbs up since that will help the channel a lot. Now with the disclosures away, let's start by reviewing the Sakumaru from Fine King. The Sakumaru from Fine King is packaged in a wooden box. The knife is protected with a saya and there's enough padding to protect the blade. You also get the microfiber cloth. The Sakumaru from Fine King has an SKD 11 core and comes with an outer, softer stainless steel cladding. The cladding is very visible and adds to the aesthetics of the knife. The knife also comes with a traditional wa handle with an octagon shape. The knife Rockwell hardness is specified with a Rockwell of 62 plus or minus 2. But during my testing, the Rockwell was close to 63. SKD 11 has an excellent stainless property, so you don't have to worry about rusting. Because it is a single bevel knife with a high Rockwell, you need to be delicate with the edge. It means that you can only use it to slice through soft produce like boneless salmon and tuna. If you put the knife flat at the shinogi line, then the knife has a 10 degrees shinogi face. However, they lifted the blade with 2 degrees, so you get a 12 degrees single beveled edge. The flat side has a concave and is sharpened at 0 degrees. In other words, completely flat. The knife has some layered Damascus patterns, which only adds to the aesthetics. However, if you look at the shinogi line, you see multiple layers which helps to create air pockets for food release. If you also look closely, the shinogi line also has a slight convex face. This convex face is extremely important and therefore should not be removed. With this in mind, I understand why Fine King did not go for a 10 degree angle but added 2 degrees to the shinogi face to create a separate single beveled edge. Keep in mind that this is a Sakumaru and not the Yanagiba. It means that the blade profile is pretty much completely flat. It has the correct profile for specialized tasks. If you work in a sushi restaurant and you need to prep tuna, you know that we create even rectangular sizes. This knife is excellent for that purpose. And here you can see tuna prep work and how we cut rectangular sizes. As for nigiri slices, a yanagiba is better with that task because of the gently curved profile. With the Sakumaru, you need to adjust your slicing style to accommodate the straighter profile for nigiri slices. Since tuna and salmon are quite expensive, here you can see me prepare nigiri slices with a mango. The knife balance point is at the logo area, which makes the knife front heavy. Since this is a Sakumaru, you hold the knife with a fingertip grip and you let the knife do the work. So use the weight of the knife and the complete length to preserve freshness. Every sushi chef will tell you to slice and not to crush. And that is why sushi knives are long, narrow and single beveled. The front heavy knife will force you to use the knife's weight and length to do the work for you, so you don't have to apply any extra downward force of your own. In this example, we use a plunge cut versus a slicing motion. You will see that the plunge cut is tearing the mango flesh. And the slice is a lot cleaner. And therefore, the mango will stay longer fresh after it has been cut. As you can see, the left plunge cut has torn fibers and the right side has a clean cut. The traditional wa handle is an octagon handle, which is a well-balanced design for comfort and grip. The handle comes with ebony wood in the middle and sapel wood at the top and bottom. You also have copper dividers and a copper finish at the top instead of glue. When the handle feels dry, you can apply a thin layer of mineral oil from time to time. The fit and finish are excellent, from the concave at the back and the convex shinogi face with the added 2 degrees beveled edge. They have added everything that you can expect from a specialized knife and more. The knife weight is around 280 grams. The knife comes with a spine taper with 3.7mm at the heel, 3.2mm at the middle and 2.0mm at the front. The knife is very stiff and there's no flex during use. This knife is highly specialized and therefore it is not suitable for home cooks. Even for professional cooks, this knife limits usage and is primarily used on a specific task like tuna prep work. While it also works for salmon prep work, I prefer a Yanagiba over a Sakimaru for salmon. It is a highly specialized knife and even going through AB tempura will increase the chipping rate on the blade. Since this is a single beveled knife, you should never use a honing rod on this knife. You should also never sharpen this knife flat on the shinogi face. Since the shinogi face area has a slight convex, you destroy the added convex purpose and eliminate the layered lines that create air pockets. It is advisable to lift the knife and do not sharpen it flat on the shinogi face. It would be best if you always preserve the concave on the flat side of this knife. Without the concave, the knife is destroyed. Therefore, your stone should always be completely flat if you sharpen the single beveled knife or only remove the burr on the concave side but do not at an angle. This knife is only suitable for delicate use. Going through anything semi-hard like an AB tempura will increase the chances of chipping. I like the added saya, but I am not entirely sure about the wooden box. I wish that they included a cheaper alternative by excluding the wooden box. As a specialized knife, I am very impressed with what Fine King is delivering, and that for an unbelievable price point. Despite the lovely and fantastic price point for what they deliver, the Sakimaru is a highly specialized knife. Therefore, it is not suitable for domestic use and only ideal for a select few professional cooks specializing in Japanese cuisine. A Yanagiba is more versatile, so I advise the Yanagiba over the Sakimaru unless you do a lot of specialized prep work like tuna. That's it for this video. If you have any questions or other opinions, leave them in the comment section below. If it helped you decide, please give this video a thumbs up since that will help the channel a lot. If you want to know more about cooking and knives, please subscribe and hit the bell to get notified. Thank you for watching and I see you in the next video.